get started. So drivers, step behind those lines. We'll get started in 3, 2, 1, go.
And they're off, ladies and gentlemen. Red Alliance and Blue Alliance scoring quickly here during the autonomous period. Robots are using their onboard sensors and their superior programming to accomplish a task early on. Period comes to a close, unofficially 40 to 37, very close one. Red Alliance with the advantage as we enter into the teleoperated period. Drivers have moved past the line and have taken the controls and now are guiding their machines on the field. Riding alongside first team 2783, they maneuver around their partner at the trench, now position themselves to shoot. All five fuel cells impacted on the surface, but none went in. Mavericks are using their great intake to pick up three fuel cells, reposition themselves. Now at the end of the Blue Alliance trench, they shoot. One goes in, two goes in. Last one may have gone in through the inner port, adding more points. Now the action shifts to the Red Alliance side. Watching as 695 makes their move. Bison Robotics using their intake at the rendezvous point to pick up some additional fuel cells. 1014 also comes down through the trench, shoots and scores fuel cells through the high outer port. Mavericks again with more power cells, maneuvering to get into position to score again for the Blue Alliance. Their partner, EOT, the Engineers of Tomorrow, they're hauling the mail. They deliver their special packages. Now move off to grab some more. Endgame is now underway. Mavericks are in position. They reach up to grab onto the shield generator switch. Their alliance partner, Engineers of Tomorrow, are already there. 1014 looking to get in position. Unable to connect. Mavericks are elevated. 2783 appears to be so. Red Alliance team Pybotics, that's 3814. Sky first. It'll be the Blue Alliance with the win. They'll pick up the two ranking points. Blue Alliance able to score 50 points during the end game and scored 69 power cells during the course of that match.